Hello everyone, in this tutorial we are going to create a flat portrait illustration using reference image in Inkscape. Okay, let's get into it. Alright, first let's import the image in file, import, and just this. Let's hit open and click OK. You can hold Ctrl on the keyboard to lock when scaling like this. Then let's make it fit with the document, so let's click the picture. Change it to pixel. As you can see, this is the width, so just going to copy it and go to file, document properties, change the units to pixel first, and you can change the width as the same with the picture by paste it, then close. Let's rename this layer for the picture and lock it. You can click this lock icon to lock the picture and create new layer and name it. Start to trace it with Bezier tool, but first you must define what parts must become the path. For example, I want to trace the face, the hair, and the clothes. Press B to activate the Bezier tool. You can start from here and follow the face shape. You can click and drag like this. On here, we can hold shift to lock the corner and release and connect it to the start point. For the hair, press B again, start from here, just follow the hair shape. We're not working on detail, just to make it smooth, make some less notes like this. Click here from the edge of the page to here. Connect it to the start point. For the neck, press B again. Start from here. For the clothes, you can hold shift to lock the corner, then release like this. Just make it to the edge of the page and hold shift again to lock the corner and release. Click to here and here. Connect it to the start point. Let's see. Create the eyeglasses with the circle tool, click this icon, and you can hold shift to make it fit with the reference image, and duplicate to another one, press Ctrl D, and place it on here. Then draw this part with the Bezier tool, press B, and I start from here. This part, you can hold shift to lock the corner, like this. And then release. Click again. Make some curve. Can drag like this. Then hold shift to lock the corner. Then connect it to the start point. And for this part, for the nostril, press B again. And make some curves like this. And to here. And connect it to the first point with, you can drag like this. For the lips, with Bezier tool again, just follow the shape but not to details. And for this inner part, connect it to here. Alright, now let's give some color to our illustration. Hide this image layer. And you can click this object and press D to activate the Dropper tool. And click this color. It will change to this color, or you can input this color code to here. And let's change it. Give the skin color to white. And you can remove the stroke by selecting all and right-click, choose remove stroke. Make some background with this rectangle tool, click this icon. Make sure the snap to the back border is inactive and start from here until you see this tooltip and just connect it to here. Press D and change it to this color. Click the move tool, bring it to the bottom. What's next is we are going to rewind this part to make it more smooth. So the key is the last note is the smoother, right? You can press F2 to enter the edit mode and you see this note. Just delete this part, press delete button and rank it like this. You can drag this handle, just make it fit. And this hair part, you can delete this note, press delete on the keyboard and drag this handle and this too. Just keep the note in less number and on this part can drag it . You can move this part to the back, press F1 and click this icon. Oops, okay. And for the clothes, just pull it over here. Refine this lip shape. Just make it precise. Just bring the hair to front, you can click this and this icon. Let's refine it. You can double click to add the notes and place it on here. Drag this. You can drag this too. Sorry, I forgot to draw the eyebrows, my bad. Just change it to stroke to see what's through it, and this background, turn it to stroke and turn on this image layer. Press B again, draw the eyebrow shape with bezier tool, press B and just follow the shape. You can hold shift to lock the corner, then release and connect it to here. Right, for the other side. And these earrings with bezier tool, press B. Follow the shape. You can right click to release. Let's change the color to this color and remove the stroke. And for the earrings, you can press D and hold shift to make the stroke as this yellow color, then click. And let's make the stroke to 3 pixels. You can turn it back by change the stroke to fill, right click, swap fill and stroke. And for the background, right click, swap fill and stroke. And turn off this image layer. Next, we are going to create some shade to make it look nicer with bezier tool again. Press B and start from here. You can hold shift to lock the corner, then release. Hold shift again. Connect it to the stroke point and take it to this color. Move the stroke by right click, choose remove stroke. And duplicate the neck part, press Ctrl D. Want to make some intersection by selecting this path first and shift click this part and go to path, choose the intersection so it will intersect this part. You can refine it again, press F2, start to move it. Next, for the face part, press B again and start to draw from here. Right, you can turn off this snipping if it disturbs you. Right, let me undo it and try again. Change it to this color. Move the stroke. Press F1 and move it to the back. Refine it, press F2. And you can drag the handle. And for this part, convert it to path first. By going to path, choose stroke to path because this is the stroke one. Duplicate the face layer, press Ctrl D and click this part, shift click, and go to path, choose the difference. Now it's clean. I want to make some definition of the face here. And duplicate the face layer, press Ctrl D and duplicate again, press Ctrl D again. Change the color to see what happened. Right around here. You can click this red part first and here, go to path, choose the difference. Right, let's refine it a little. And send it to the lower back. And the last thing for this part, press B again and draw some shade like this. Hold shift to lock the corner, then release. You can click here and here. Change the color to this color and move it to the lower back. Refine it. And this too. Seems out for me, so I just delete this part. Alright, there you go. Hope you learned something new, how to create this flat portrait illustration with tracing method in Inkscape. Just keep the note in a less number and keep the shape in smooth. Keep practicing. I'm Zakir from Zakir Design. Create something good today. Thanks for watching.